Yes, we are, Terrell.
Bout number two, Garrett Greppy. Make your way to the blue corner, please.
All right, and Garrett Greffey making his way to the cage. He is currently 1-1, standing 6 foot tall, 23 years of age, out of Forsyth, Montana. He's an independent fighter, and I cannot wait. This is a 170-pound welterweight bout. He weighed in yesterday at 162 pounds.
Oh, a little
under
shy.
The weight. Yeah. Apparently a natural 155-er, I'm thinking.
I would guess so, but he doesn't seem like he wants to cut weight. You know, I know his opponent, Eric the Avocado Storicho, and a good friend of mine and also a training partner. This is Eric's, I believe, 10th fight?
11th.
He's 5-5. Okay, so it's 11th fight. This should be interesting.
Agreed. And Garrett, 1-1. He lost his last fight, won his first fight by arm triangle, in impressive fashion, honestly. It was a very, very good performance at the Reno Club in Billings. And Eric Storicho, boxer. He likes to stand. He likes to keep it on the feet. And it's going to be an interesting clash of styles between these two gentlemen.
Eric is one of the toughest guys I know.
Oh,
you
yeah.
know what? He's not much for being flashy or technical, but he marches forward and throws punches. I always tell him he's made out of bone and sinew, and you don't want to get hit by him because you're probably going to hurt.
Fair
get
enough.
Hurt, you know? And so I'm excited for this fight. Whenever Eric fights, it's always fireworks.
100%. And there's his opponent, Garrett Greffey, making his way into the cage. And this is, again, a non-title amateur bout. That means 3 3-minute rounds.
And we have a new ref in the cage this evening.
Dennis.
Sergio to the red corner, please.
And Eric, the Avocado Storicho, no stranger to the Fusion Fight League cage. I'm pretty sure every one of his fights has been for Fusion, if I'm not mistaken. He might have had some fight force in there, but I'm pretty sure almost every one of his fights has been with Fusion, and I've had the pleasure to call numerous Eric the Avocado Storicho fights. And let me tell you, when he gets a game opponent that's ready to just stand and bang, they are wars. He had a pair of fights with a gentleman here a couple years back that was just incredible. I mean, they would just stand there and swing. And as you said earlier, maybe not the most technical, but gosh darn it if it wasn't entertaining.
Eric is not one to shy away from throwing bombs at each other. He does not take a back step. Eric is always game
yes.
bred, if you will.
And a United States military veteran.
Yes.
There you see his trunks, a U.S. Army veteran. And with Veterans Day coming up, we throw out a huge thank you to all of our veterans, all of our military members that are currently serving, that are currently overseas. Thank you guys very, very much for your sacrifice.
Most certainly.
And Samantha is walking around the round one ring card. There you see the Avocado giving a big thumbs up.
That's your Fusion Fight girl, Samantha, letting you know round number one.
You know, Travis, I kind of like to refer to myself as an avocado. I'm fat. But I'm good fat.
There you go. There you go. There you see the tail of the tape. Big age discrepancy. 39 for Storicho, 23 for Greffey. Both fighters, 500. 1-1 versus 5-5. As Terrell just said, an unfamiliar face to me, but very happy to know him. Dennis Bain, he's going to be our third man in the ring tonight, Cage, excuse me, giving his fighters some last-minute instruction.
They touch gloves, and here we are, our second fight of the evening.
That's right, second fight, and again, amateur, non-title, 3 3-minute rounds, brought to you by The Glass Doctor, Fusion Fight League's newest sponsor. Very happy to have them along.
I believe Eric is, what, 45 years old?
39.
30. Oh, I was a little off. 39, but still, no youngster.
No.
And he comes out swinging.
Big hooks.
Oh, and
it's the avocado.
Griffey on a street that he does not know the name of.
Flying kick there by Sturcio attempted.
Flying knee kick.
Yeah,
I think.
The avocado coming out swinging. I think Garrett's going to look to take this fight to the ground. He's getting caught pretty good.
I don't think this fight's going to get out of this first round. Both men just teeing off on each other.
Slip there by Garrett. Another left hand as he backed up against the cage.
And, okay, Griffey going to pull guard here.
Off the cage. Nice job pushing off the cage to pull guard
there. Eric's got to watch the triangle
and
here.
He's getting into triangle position.
He needs to posture up. He cannot keep his head down there like that, or Griffey can cinch up this triangle.
And it's not super tight yet. As you see, his foot's not 100% underneath the knee on that right side of Garrett Griffey. Now he's kind of trying to do a little bit of an armbar transition.
Okay. Now Eric postures up. Griffey just is about to pull his ankle into his knee.
There's still some space there, but it is getting tighter. Eric Sturcio's arm is across the body. He needs to get that left arm back on his left side. But it seems he's not in too much danger. There's still space there, but again, closing up.
Eric really needs to pull his head up. He has to posture up here. He's almost in a triangle.
And he's doing a great job.
Kind of a bit of a stalemate right now. Eric still staying alive. Griffey.
Again, that triangle's getting tighter and tighter.
Oh.
And also running that arm bar, trying to get something to work.
Eric with a few shots to the head.
Yeah. With that first flurry by Sturcio, Garrett had to do something.
Oh, they exchanged shots.
And the
Eric Sturcio. Oh, but that just tightened up that triangle.
Yes, it did.
Eric has to do something big here, something significant. He's got to get out of it.
45 seconds left in the round. Hopefully he can hang on or escape.
Eric is, I can see his eyes in the.
He's wincing a little bit.
He's hanging in there. Oh, that's starting to look tight, Travis.
Yep,
this could
Greffy's
be the end of
down
it.
On the head.
Eric is a tough hombre. He might actually go out here without tapping. We'll see. He's got to posture up, and he could still. We only have 20 seconds left.
Yep.
He's still alive.
He is. He's still moving around, still throwing punches.
Like I said, Eric is not one to tap. He's a tough hombre. Griffey pulling the head down, trying to tighten it up.
10 seconds to go in this round. Can Eric hold on?
5 seconds left, and Eric still seems alive.
Looking for a little
Two,
bit of a slam.
Two, one. Wow. And he stays alive.
Who do we give that round to?
I don't know. Eric a little wobbly. But
so is Griffey, it looks like.
Yeah, you know, Eric a little short on air, but Griffey burned his quads and hammies out, pulling that triangle. He tried, I mean, that was about half a round.
I was going to say about a minute and a half he had that triangle sunk in. And as you said, Casey, that just completely burns out your legs. I'm not, you know, I can't speak to how his legs feel right now, but he was pulling pretty hard on that triangle,
right.
And it looked like that he was squeezing pretty good, especially when he got down to pulling on Eric's head.
Right. Both fighters taking some big breaths in the corner there.
Yes.
See if Griffey, or Griffey?
Yep.
Griffey.
Griffey.
You know, he started to weather a little bit of a storm from Eric, and then he decided to pull guard. We'll see what his game plan is for the second round.
Definitely.
If he's going to go immediately for the takedown or try to stand again. He was not getting the best of the exchanges when he was standing.
He wasn't, but he put a few marks on Eric's face.
Certainly.
Eric certainly has some, bruising to that nose there. But, yeah, just a great start out of the gate by Sturcio, as we said. Greffy pulled guard and had that triangle in position for the better half of the round, so very tough round to call.
Here we go, round two of our second fight.
Round two starts in our second fight of the evening, brought to you by the Glass Doctor. Ooh. Eric with a nice right hand there.
To the body, Eric goes.
Right hand
seven,
to the body.
Eight, nine.
And Greffy looking to
ten.
Throw that leg up again.
About 12 shots to the body,
yeah.
Eric delivers.
And big right hands, too.
Ooh!
Left rights by Garrett Greffy.
Big left hand landed by Greffy there. Kind of stumbled Eric the Avocado.
And another left by Greffy.
Loading up that right hand is Griffey. Oh, and he goes for a takedown, and he winds up on top.
A little scramble there. Good outside trip by Greffy.
Let's see what Eric does here. If he's going to throw up any submissions. If I know Eric well enough, he's going to just try to.
And he's got a
he throws
gosh,
up
Casey
a triangle.
Oh, my gosh.
And he's delivering some shots. Oh, my gosh.
He's
that
got
was so
it.
Quick.
He's if he not were to pull back on that yeah. leg and cinch the head down, he might have it.
He's not. I don't know what his
going
corner.
For an arm bar, it looks like.
His corner, as you guys can see, is right in the background. They're going to probably give him some advice. I think if he cinched down that triangle, he could possibly finish this match. Greffy,
I think he's going
is,
for a toe hold? Oh, he's
I'm
trying
not,
for something there.
I'm not quite sure why you would do that when you have someone in a triangle, but we don't know what's going on here. He needs to grab the head of Greffy, mm-hmm. pull it down, and cinch down this triangle, and he could finish this match.
And I'd like to see him go to a mounted triangle. Right now there's not a lot of pressure on the legs.
Correct.
And from that top position, he is trying for a toe hold. A little bit of a heel hook?
Like you said, Travis, if he just brings his hips up, comes up on top, he can wind up on top with a mounted triangle.
And he just needs to keep putting his weight to the direction he's going.
He lets the triangle go. Oh
and it's
tightened
down.
It.
See, now that he's on that hip, on the right hip of Eric's right hip on Greffy, that makes it a lot tighter. And as you said, if he were to pull that arm across Greffy's head, pull back on the head, he might have it cinched down.
Greffy doing a good job keeping his legs in Eric's face, mm-hmm. kind of surviving. But his head is, from here, cage side, his head's turning red.
Yeah, Sturcio is squeezing very tight.
Not quite sure why Eric isn't locking up this triangle and trying to finish it.
25 seconds to go in round number two.
Eric,
10 seconds left in round two. Sorry.
Delivering some hammer fists, but it looks like we're going to go into round three.
And a dominant round by Eric Sturcio.
I agree.
All right. That is the end of round number two. We are on to our third and final round in our second bout of the evening. And both of these guys looking a little tired and, you know,
big
deservedly
breath.
So. Yeah, they're going
big,
after it in there.
Big breath from both men. You know, this has been a back and forth little battle here. Both men have been caught up in some triangles.
Yep. And here we see a replay again. Eric with those like 10, 12 unanswered body shots to the left side of Garrett Greffy. And just fall. Yeah. Eric, as you were saying, you didn't know if he was going to throw any submissions. He tossed up that triangle quick and in a hurry. And he used it more as a offensive tactic
right.
rather than to finish
way
the fight.
To sweep.
But hey.
Curious to see what the corner men are telling both these men. I don't know what I would say. You know, do you wind up on the ground? Both of them have wound up in triangles.
Yep.
Do you stay on your feet? Both men have exchanged big shots. Curious yeah. to see how this third round goes.
I agree 100%. Here you can see a little bit of blood on the nose. Eric Sturcio, again, has taken some good shots from Garrett Greffy.
It wouldn't be Eric if he didn't have his nose broke.
True. And one of the first rounds I've seen from Mr. Sturcio, one of the first third rounds I've seen in quite a while from him. Typically, he finishes it quick.
Correct.
And he almost did in that first round, too. All right, and our referee, Dennis, checking with the fighters and the judges.
Here we go, round three.
3 minutes left in our second bout of the evening. Brought to you by the Glass Doctor.
I'm watching Eric. He's looking. He's tired. He's taking some big breaths.
Ooh, big right hand there by Greffy.
Greffey looking a little bit more spry, but Eric still marches forward and throws some big shots. Both men teeing off on each other. Oh, big shot landed on Eric. He got wobbled there for a second.
Big exchanges by these gentlemen up close to the cage.
Now Greffey taking a big breath.
And a big right hand by Greffey. Boom, another big right hand.
Eric's still marching forward.
Yep, and these guys are just throwing.
Both men take another big breath. They both look tired, but they're both not afraid to exchange.
Good sidekick there by Greffey to the midsection. And another goes high with it.
Oh! Greffey just landed a huge right hand, and he throws another. Eric still marching forward, hands down.
Ooh, throws nice a body kick by Sturcio, and they're just up against the cage, so winging.
They are
the
right.
The crowd is getting louder.
They're right in front of us, Travis, and both men are exchanging
big
punches.
Shots.
Greffey kind of stumbles away. Eric, hands at his side. This is one for the fans.
Yeah, it is. Big left hand by Greffey. Body kick by Sturcio. Left hand by Greffey.
Wow.
Body kick and a right hand.
What an exciting fight.
Oh, my gosh, these guys are swinging.
Oh, Eric eats another.
Minute
and
15
a third.
Left. And Greffey swinging for the fences again. Seems that he cannot put the avocado away.
Oh, Eric eats like a 10th shot again, and he's still standing there. Eric
Both
seems
of these
to be back.
Staring each other down.
Yeah. Eric seems to be on his heels now, and Greffey marching forward, but it's been a back and forth, and now Eric comes marching forward again.
Some big punches of his own. And these guys are exhausted, swinging for the fences, putting everything that they have left into those punches. Oh, and another big hand, right hand by Greffey.
That big overhand right is landed for Greffey, about five. If you see the left side of Eric's face, it's bloody. He must have cut him open, and he lands it
another
again.
Another big right hand. Eric with his hands at his sides. Both guys marching forward, stumbling back. This is a great fight.
And we only have 20 seconds left, and there's that right hand by Greffey again.
And another.
Oh, my goodness, Travis. This is one heck of a
two dogs
barn burner.
In this cage.
Oh,
yes.
And he lands it again. Both men.
And they're going to swing until the very end. Oh, Sturcio up against the cage. Greffey teeing off. 5 seconds to go in the third round. Oh, and that is it.
Wow.
The end of our second bout of the evening. And both of these guys put all they had into that fight. Wow.
You know, Travis, that's a hard one for me now that I'm thinking about scoring that. You know,
very difficult. Very, very difficult to score.
The first two rounds could have been either or. That last one, Eric did really well. Greffey kind of came back at the end. I don't know where
Big
to go.
Toss up.
We'll see what our judges say.
And as Terrell just said, these instant replays are nuts.
Wow, what a scrap. One for the fans out there.
Definitely. Great job by both of these gentlemen. Great job. And I know for a fact we're going to see both of them back in the fusion cage again.
Like I said, Eric's such a good guy. You know, he's made out of bone and sinew, and he might not be the most technical, but he marches forward, and he will stand in the pocket with anyone, and that's exactly what these two gentlemen did this evening.
100%. Like I said, they just put all they had, heart and soul, into the cage this evening, and the fans respect them for it that much more, man.
Fighters to the center, please. Curious to see how this goes, Travis.
Brought to you by Glass Doctor, your winner by split decision, Garrett Greffey.
Ooh. Tough fight.
It certainly was, and that could have gone either way.